than 20 species of sea snakes that inhabit the coastal and offshore waters of Queensland. All are protected under state and federal legislation. It's rumoured that sea snakes are unable to bite and inject their venom into humans because they either cannot open their mouths wide enough or because their teeth are too small or positioned at the back of the jaw. This is not the case. Like their land-based cousins, sea snakes are highly venomous and should always be handled with great caution. Of the many different methods used to catch seafood in Queensland, trawling is the most likely to result in fishers having a need to interact with sea snakes, especially in warm tropical waters. Research has demonstrated that sea snake bycatch in the Queensland trawl fishery can be significantly reduced by the use of properly designed and installed bycatch reduction devices, such as the fisheye. In the event of sea snakes being captured during trawl operations, the use of correct handling methods, appropriate handling equipment, and personal protective equipment can minimise the risk to humans, as well as maximise the chances of sea snake survival. Like many wild animals, sea snakes are most likely to become aggressive when taken out of their natural environment and placed in an unusual situation. As a general rule, the total time of physical contact between a sea snake and the handler should not exceed 5 seconds. The longer the handling time, the more likely it is that the sea snake will bite. It's very important that the handler never takes their eyes off a snake that he or she is handling. If there is more than one sea snake on the sorting tray, have another crew member control the other snake while the handler releases the first snake. To reduce the risk of injury to fishers who interact with sea snakes, the use of handling equipment is recommended. Snake tongs and snake hooks can be used to release a sea snake back into the water without the handler coming into direct contact with it. When using snake tongs, aim to close the tongs in the middle of the snake's body, not near the head or the tail. When the handler is confident that the snake is in a secure grip, gently lower the snake into the water. Flattened tongs are recommended, as they pose little or no risk to the animal being crushed. If using snake hooks, first clear the snake from the net or catch by hooking it as close to the centre of the body as possible. Next, using the snake hook, gently herd the animal towards the discard chute to be returned to the water. Alternatively, grip the sea snake about a third of the length of the body from the tail. Then, in a smooth, purposeful motion, lower the snake over the side of the boat and gently release it into the water. The use of a snake hook can help support the snake and gain more control of its head. It also greatly reduces the chances of being bitten. If a snake becomes entangled in the net, it may be necessary to cut one or two meshes so that the snake can easily be removed. First, position the net so that the area that the snake is entangled in is easily accessible. Then, place a firm grip with your hand behind the snake's head and use net scissors to carefully cut one or two meshes from around the snake's head or body. When it's freed from the net, calmly return the snake to the water, being careful to never take your eyes off the snake. Returning a recovering sea snake to the water makes an easy meal for opportunistic predators. If the situation arises that a sea snake appears dead or docile, a confident and experienced handler may attempt to recover the animal on board before releasing it. This is achieved by placing the snake in a container of seawater until the snake's condition has improved. Sea snakes can absorb up to 20% of their oxygen requirements through their skin, and this recovery method has proven successful. A handler must keep in mind, however, that human safety takes priority over the survival of the animal. Commercial fishers that are likely to encounter sea snakes should carry a snake bite kit and be trained in the application of the pressure immobilization technique for treating a snake bite. A snake bite kit should include at least one heavy compression bandage, a permanent marker, a triangular bandage, and a snake bite first aid instruction card. And remember, all snake bites should be treated as serious. Should a snake bite occur, seek professional medical assistance immediately.